Hello and welcome to another episode of my Beginner's Guide to Setting Up Todoist. My name is Carl Pullein and this week I want to show you all about getting tasks into your inbox. Now, last week we covered setting up a basic project structure, so we've got home and work and a someday maybe folder. Then we moved on to actually creating a task, and finally, in the end of last week, I actually showed you how to do your settings so you can customize Todoist a little bit better so that it works for you in terms of colors and how you want notifications. Well, in this episode, what I want to do is show you how to get tasks into your inbox. Now, there are multiple ways of doing that, one of which does involve the premium paid version, which I will also cover. So in this episode, we're going to start moving a little bit into the premium services. However, that said, 90% of what I'm going to show you today is part of the free Todoist experience. Okay, so let me take you into my demo account now, and I'm going to show you all the different ways that you can get tasks into your Todoist. Okay, so I've previously showed you a number of ways when we were looking at tasks of getting tasks into your Todoist. What I want to do is do a quick review of those. So let's have a look at the first one. The easiest way to do it is just click on the Add Task button here, and I can do test one. So we're going to see how many that we can actually do. If I hit return, I can just type in test two, and I can keep adding tasks there. To come out of that, by the way, we just click on cancel. That's one way. Another way is to hit the plus button up here, which will add a task. So we'll call this task three, and that's done. And another one is to just hit Q. So Q stands for quick entry, and that's going to give me another one. So we're going to call that test, I think, four. Yep. And I don't know why, because I've tested Q. So let's just let's get rid of the Q because I want to keep this nice and simple. So there we go. So we've done that, save that, come out of that. So that's four ways of getting tasks directly into your inbox. And as you can see, it's incredibly fast. Now there's another way that you can do it, which if you go to the Todoist menu up here, now I believe this is also the same on Windows, but you may have to check. If you go into your preferences, you come to shortcuts. Now shortcuts here gives you a number of options. Show hide Todoist, and I'll show you that in a minute, just gives me this. So if I go Shift T and Shift T, it doesn't work. Maybe it's Control T, there we go, and Control T should bring it back. No, it doesn't. Oh, I never play with that one, so let's not play with that one. That's boring. Okay, so what I'm going to do is the one that you really want to be looking at is this here, quick add task, which is shift, in my case, shift command A. You can click out the cross sign there and you can add your own. I just like shift command A. So if I type now shift command A, I can do test number five. There we go. So that's five ways of getting tasks into your inbox really, really fast. Now let's go into a little bit more complex. So first up, what we need to do is to get the web clipper. So I've got a web clipper up here for Todoist. And you'll see here, to get, if you're using Safari, you can download that directly from the Mac App Store. Now, don't worry, for those of you guys who are not using Todoist on your desktop or your computer, don't worry. I will be, in a future episode, I will be covering how to do all this in a mobile device. So, okay, that's one way. And what I'm going to do is, let's just go here, how it works. And I want to clip that directly to my inbox. So all I have to do is click there and you'll see it's got the actual details here. I can just add the task, boom. Now if we go back to there, you'll see that now it's come there and it is a clickable link. Now this computer is set up for Chrome, so this has opened up in Chrome. Speaking of Chrome, let's come out of that one. You can go to the Chrome Web Store and you can get to, now you've got two options here, so you've got to be careful here. So Todoist for Chrome is here, and Todoist for Gmail. I would suggest you get both. So when you get Todoist for Chrome, you get the extension up here. So we click on that, and that now gives me an extension option here, and I have all my tasks here. Now what I can do is I can add this website as a task, bang. So I add that, add task, and that's now added. And as you can see,
that's also become a clickable link. So that's how fast you can get it in. And by the way, if I go to here, you'll see that it's already updated on my main item. So that's one way that you can get tasks directly into your inbox. Now let's go to Gmail. So I'm just going to click on here and we'll go to Gmail. And I don't use Gmail very often from this computer, but what I want to do is to show you what you can do from here. So from Gmail, what I can do is, let's say this Brian Tracy one here, I can open this and I can say, now remember, I've got the actual extension added, so I can, you can tell I don't use this very often. What I can do is I can use add to Todoist, which is a little icon here. So I click that, I can add the task to Todoist. And it's added. But the beauty of adding Gmail is I get this little icon here, which tells me this is an email. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click out of that. I'm going to go back to my original one. Now, this hasn't updated. It has now. It's just come in. You saw that. Now, the thing about doing it directly from Gmail like this is if I click on that now, that's going to take me to my Gmail interface and it's going to open up the actual mail. So I can go straight to that email if I wish. That's one of the fantastic things about that. And also, if I click on here, it doesn't actually add a comment. Now, if you do this from, say, Mac Mail, you don't get a clickable link, in as much as what will happen is you'll get like a link in your comments, which will open up the email via Todoist server. I think it works like that. But there you go. So that's a number of ways that you can get your tasks into Todoist. Now it does take a little bit of setting up to do. Now, how do you do the email? What you can do is one more, if you're not using Chrome, you can actually get the email address for your inbox. Now, if I click on this, I can email tasks to this project. So I've got this here. And if I copy that to clipboard and I go to my Apple Mail, so here's my Apple Mail, so let's just go into this one. And what I should point out now is to get the actual email address is a premium version. I've actually done that this morning. So it cost me 41,000 won. That's about, I guess, probably about $30. I'm not sure exactly what the conversion rate is. But let's say now I want to send this to Todoist. So I can click on here. I can just go to my forward. So let's go to forward. And that's not what I wanted to do. Sorry. Let's click out of that. Don't save. I'm going to go to this button here and it gives me the forward option. I'm going to paste the inbox in there. I'm going to click send. That's now going to go to my Todoist inbox. So let's just, there it's gone. So hopefully, is that going to come in? I will do my sync now because it might take a few minutes to come in. Is it come in? There we go. It's come in. So what I want to do is show you what happens with this. If I click on that, I will have to click on that and that will then open up the email here. But if you look at the email address, I don't know where this is coming from, but anyway, it's, the email is actually here. So that's another way of getting tasks into your system. So there you go. There's, I think we've now got 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 ways of getting tasks into your inbox. There's quite a few of them to go through there. What I would recommend is you go and get the actual web clippers for either whichever web browser you're using, whether it's Chrome or Safari. Also get that if you're using the premium, if you're ready to upgrade to the premium, then you can actually get the email address for your inbox and you can start sending email. But if you're using Chrome, you don't need that function because Chrome is a free, we go to the Chrome one, it is over here, the Chrome add-on is free, so you can actually get round that subscription thing by using the system here. Well, I think I've given you a lot to think about, a lot to play with this week, so I will end it there. Thank you very much for watching this episode, and it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.